Hello everyone. So last class we have solved this question. So let us try to solve another question in this class. So let us read it. So determine the components of the 1000 Newton force along the axis A and B as shown in figure. So we have to find out the component of this force along this axis, that B and A. Okay. And compare these components with the rectangular x and y components. Okay, so after finding the value of the component of this force along this axis, that is A and B, after that we have to compare with the rectangular x and y components. That means we have to find out the components of this force along A and B as well as along x and y when we'll be taking as a rectangular component. Okay, so what we need to find out, let us see that. So what is given here? It is given, F is given as 1000 Newton, and we need to find out FA, FB and FX and FP. Okay, sorry, that is FY, it is not B, it is FY. Okay, so if we'll be trying to draw the parallelogram, so if we'll be taking the B and A first, okay, so we'll be getting FA along this and FB along this. So as we can take this is as the resultant, and we have to resolve this along A and B. So we can construct a parallelogram by taking these two forces as the adjacent sides. So FA will be one side and FB, so this is not EB, this is FB. Okay, so by mistake it is written as EB, so it is FB. Okay, so FB will be another side. Okay, so by taking these two sides we can construct a parallelogram. So we can construct a parallelogram like this. So now what we need to do, we need to find out the values of FB and FA. So by using the parallelogram we can construct. Okay, so let us try to find out all these angles now. So F is inclined to A as 30 degree, so we can say this is 30 degree, and this total angle it is given as 80 degree, so we can say this will be 50 degree, and this total angle will be your 80 degree. So let us try to draw a triangle. So here we can use the triangle law, that your sine law we can say. So let us first draw that triangle over here. Okay, so if we'll be trying to draw that triangle, then this will be one side and this will be one side, and this FB we can represent over here. So the magnitude of these two sides will be equal, so we can plot this FB over here, so we can get this triangle. So let us draw that. Okay, so angles, before that we can say all these angles alpha, this I can denote this total angle as alpha, and this as your gamma, and this is as your beta. So this values I can get alpha, beta, gamma as 80 and 50 and 30 degree. So let us draw that triangle over here. So if I'll be drawing this triangle, then AD, so this side will be this one FA, and this will be resultant F, and this will be FB. So it is not FA, that will be FB. Okay, so FB will be represented as this one. So this angle already we know that is 30 degree as like this one, and this is 50, so that we can say this will be also 50. Okay, so this angle will be also 50, that we can represent over here, and this is 30, this is 50, means this two total will be your 80, so that this angle will be your 100, because the summation of all the angles inside any triangle will give us that is 180. Okay, so now easily we can use the sine law, that says that your ratio of any side and sine of that opposite angle to that side will be equal. Okay, so here we can say FA, so FA divided by its sine of the opposite side, so opposite angle is given as 50 degree, so So sine of 50, okay, the ratio of FA and sine 50 will be equal to what? FB and sine 30, and that will be equal to F by sine 100. So let us write that. So by using the sine law, we can write this equation, that is FA by sine 50, that will be equal to FB divided by sine 30, and that will be equal to F by sine 100. Okay. So now if I'll be comparing with these two equations, so for finding FA, I have to compare this with this. So from here, F is known to us, and we can calculate all these values like sine 50 and sine 100, so that I can find out the value of FA. So let us find out that. So if I'll be trying to find out FA, then I can calculate as your 777.86 Newton. So easily you can calculate by using the scientific calculator. So FA can be calculated as 777.86. So likewise, you can compare these two equations, these two terms, that is FB by sine 30, that will be equal to F by sine 100 degree. So if we will be comparing that, then we can write as your FB will be equal to F sine 30 divided by sine 100, where the value of F is 1000. So we can calculate the value of FB as 507.71 Newton. So FB can be calculated as this value. So now what we need to do, we need to find out the values of fx and fy as if we will be taking inside a rectangle. Okay. So if we will be constructing a rectangle by taking this force as the resultant, then how can we draw that? So simply if this will be the resultant, then we can draw a vertical line over here. Sorry. So this vertical line will give me the magnitude of fy. Okay. So if I'll be constructing a vertical line like this, then I can find a value of that magnitude will give me the magnitude of fx, and this magnitude up to this point will give me the value of fx. Okay, so this will be fy and this will be fx. So let us draw that rectangle. Okay, so if we'll be drawing that rectangle, then we can get a rectangle like this, where this will be the fy and this we can say this is as fx. So for that this angle we can say as this is 30 degree, so this will be also 30 degree. Okay, so if this is 30 degree, obviously this angle will be equal to 60 degree. So we have got a rectangle like this. So from that we can get a triangle, that if we'll be taking ACD as a triangle, then we can draw a triangle like this. So after drawing this triangle, simply we can find out the value of fx and fy if all these angles are known to us, and the magnitude of f is also known to us. So simply we can find out the value of fx and fy, and again by using the sine law also we can find out the value of fx and fy. So let us use that sine law and try to find out the value of fx and fy. So simply previously how we have find out, in that way only we have to calculate. So if we will be using the sine law in this triangle, then we can write that fx divided by sine 60, that will be equal to fy divided by sine 30, and that will be equal to f divided by your sine 90. So let us write that. So we can get an equation like this, fx divided by sine 60, that will be equal to fy will be divided by sine 30, and that will be equal to f divided by sine 90. So from here, if we'll be comparing fx, that is first term, with last term, then we can find out the value of fx. So fx can be calculated as your 866.02 Newton. Okay, so fx we can calculate as your 866.02 Newton. So likewise also if we'll be comparing your second term with third term, that is fy divided by sine 30, that will be equal to f divided by sine 90, then we can find out the value of fy. So let us do that. So if we'll be doing that, then we can calculate the value of fy as 500 Newton. So easily we have calculated all the values of these forces. So we have resulted the forces that is 100, that is 1000 Newton, which is given here along four axis. So likewise we can compare means what is the relation or what is the value of FA and FX. Likewise, what is the value of FB and FY. Okay, so simply we need to calculate it or calculate the values. So simply we have put the triangle law, that is sine law, over here by considering a triangle. So by using that sine law we calculated all these values over here. So it was easy question. So with this we have completed how to resolute any force, how to composite any force, okay, combine any force. Okay, so if there will be a number of forces, so simply by taking a two forces we can get a resultant. So that's how we can combine any two force. And if we want to resolute any force any along direction, if angle is known, then we can resolute like this also. So composition and resolution of force is completed with this question. So next class onwards we'll be starting in another chapter after discussing one concept which we have left. So after discussing that we'll be shifting to the next chapter. Okay, so for this video it's all about. So thank you for watching. So do share it with your friends whoever needs it, and do share with whom you think it will be beneficial for them. So if you like this video, then press on the like button which is given below, and if you are new here, then do subscribe it and press on the bell icon so that you will be getting all the notifications from our channel whenever we'll be uploading any new video on this. So thank you for watching.